Welcome to the first example of finding the determinant of a 3x3 matrix using the diagonal method. To use the diagonal method to find the determinant of a 3x3 matrix, we first want to form a 3x5 arrangement of elements using the elements from the given matrix. To form the 3x5 arrangement, the first columns are the same as the original matrix. The fourth column is the same as the first column, and the fifth column is the same as the second column. So once we have the 3x5 arrangement of elements, we're ready to use the diagonal method to find the value of the 3x3 determinant. The determinant of matrix A is equal to the sum of the product of the red diagonals minus the sum of the product of the green diagonals. So both of these 3x5 arrangements are the same, so the determinant will be equal to the sum of the product of these three diagonals minus the sum of the product of these three diagonals. So going back to our example, we first want to form a 3x5 arrangement using the elements from matrix A. So the first three columns will be the same as matrix A. The fourth column will be the same as the first column, so we have 3, negative 1, 2, and the fifth column will be the same as the second column. So we have 1, negative 2, 4. And now we can find the value of the determinant of matrix A. We can write it like this, or we can use vertical bars like this, which will be equal to the sum of the product of these three diagonals minus the sum of the product of these three diagonals. So we'll first sum the product of the blue diagonals, or the diagonals from the upper left to the lower right. So we'll have 3 times negative 2 times 1, that's negative 6, plus 1 times 5 times 2, that's 10, plus 2 times negative 1 times 4, that's negative 8, minus the sum of the product of the red diagonals, or the diagonals from the upper right to the lower left. So we'll have 2 times negative 2 times 2, that's negative 8, plus 3 times 5 times 4, that's 60, plus 1 times negative 1 times 1 is negative 1. So here we have negative 6 plus 10, that's 4, plus negative 8, that's negative 4, minus negative 8 plus 60, that's 52, plus negative 1, that's 51. So we have negative 4 minus 51, which is equal to negative 55. This is the value of our determinant. We'll take a look at a second example in the next video. I hope you found this helpful.